Every good presentation is essentially a good story. Now, we know when we're hearing a good story, we're paying attention, our curiosity is increasing, we understand what is being said, and if it's a really good story, then we think about it and talk about it later with our friends and colleagues. We want our scientific presentations to produce these same effects in our audience.
One really important ingredient of a good story is drama. So we've got to find the drama in our scientific issue that we're presenting. The drama might be in the importance of the issue that we're studying, or the drama might be in resolving some long-standing question, or it could be something really surprising that we've found. But the important thing is that we need to locate the drama in the work we're presenting and get excited about it. It's going to be a much better story then.
We all hate it when someone is telling a story and they're meandering around. They're putting in details that aren't that important. They're going off on tangents, and it just makes it difficult to follow the story. So one of the biggest challenges in giving effective scientific presentations is to identify the central narrative and leave out the rest. Find what's important to tell the main story and forget everything else. If people are curious about something you haven't mentioned, they can ask about it during the question and answer period.
Before you sit down to develop your slides, you need to figure out where to develop your story. Now, there are a lot of different options, so let's just cover a few. One thing you can do is simply take a blank page and focus on the flow of the story. Just get some thoughts down. Don't let anything else distract you from getting down the main narrative. Another approach is something like a mind map, which provides a more graphical representation of the story. This type of visual approach provides a different view of the narrative line you are trying to draw and may help you to recognize when particular parts of your story are becoming disproportionately long. By far the most common approach used by speakers is probably just developing their story in the actual presentation software. This is also probably the most dangerous option because it encourages you to start creating slides before you've really refined your story. Remember that the story should drive the creation of slides. The slides shouldn't be driving the creation of the story.
Let's take a few minutes to talk about using visuals to support your storytelling. Now, we're going to talk a lot about how to make slides, but for now, let's look at a few examples that illustrate how using visuals can help or hurt a presentation.
In this study, we used a fascinating array of patient-reported outcome measures, including the Weinfurt Mountain Dew Anxiety Measure, the Tom Brady Inflation Index, the Kim Kardashian Judgment Inventory, and the Hellhammer Tectonic Rage Scale.
So that was kind of dizzying because he was using presentation software animation effects all over the place. They weren't adding to the message. They were actually distracting from what he was trying to say.
Challenges. There are many challenges associated with using patient-reported outcomes in clinical research. We've made progress on some of these in the clinical research enterprise. This is particularly problematic in the area of clinical trials. And the FDA is aware of these issues and has offered some guidance in their recent documents.
What was the problem here? The visuals on the slide should support the storytelling. But in this case, the bullet points on the slide corresponded only slightly to what the presenter was saying. And so the audience is trying to read those bullets and at the same time listen to the presenter drone on.
So let's talk about challenges with patient-reported outcomes. There are too many instruments measuring the same health concept. And while some of those instrument measures are good, many are not. It is difficult to compare and combine data across studies and also to compare and combine data across conditions. And also, many measures are also too complex.
So that was incredibly painful. I felt like the presenter and I were on a journey together to discover what this talk was about by reading the bullet points as they are revealed to us. Several years ago, some colleagues and I were giving a presentation at the NIH about a relatively new initiative, and we wanted to start off this long presentation with a very clear statement about what exactly this initiative was. And so we came up with a visual support for that story that was very spare, but very effective in quickly letting people know exactly what this was about. I'm excited to tell you today about the Patient-Reported Outcome Measurement Information System, or PROMIS. PROMIS is essentially three things. First of all, PROMIS is a set of measures of both pediatric and adult health concepts. Second, PROMIS is an advancement in the science of self-reported health measurement. And finally, PROMIS is readily available software that lets you administer these newly developed measures. So to summarize, we want to find the drama. We want to include points that are critical to the storyline and leave out the rest. And finally, we want to use visuals that will support the storytelling, not distract from it.
This educational program is supported by a grant from the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences.
All right.
I'm sorry. All right, let me try it.
All right. Hold on, wait. Okay.
For example, you might be defending the thesis or
God, I had it!